Sag mal. Ja, ich für mich noch. Okay. Gib die Change. Schale.
What have you forgotten now, Lindsay?
Daddy!
Oh, hello, son! Oh, great to see you! Yeah!
Hello, Jim.
Didn't know you were coming back today.
I only made my mind up last night.
You should have phoned.
Hey, Tiger.
Have you been a good boy for your Auntie Val, have you?
No!
Oh, you're cheeky, you! Oh, yes, he is!
Hey, Clint! Jackie told me you had a talk with her yesterday.
Yeah?
She said that you agreed that we should stop fighting. Make up.
I said that for Jackie's benefit, not yours. Perhaps I can be your mate, though. In public. But I'm not going to forget that you lied about Katie.
I know. Anyway, well done, lad. Made up for you.
What are you talking about?
Jackie told me the good news.
But what?
You're marrying Katie, aren't you? Well done, lad. Really brought me up short. Made me realise just what a get I've been.
I don't believe it. That was meant to be a secret.
Well, the family, though.
You'd better not say anything to Katie.
Believe me, I'm happy for you.
I don't care how you feel about it, as long as you keep your nose out.
Penalty shootout. Goal! Not another one. I can't keep up with you. Look out, Emil Heskey. Here comes William Corkill.
I've made a cuppa if you'd like one.
Yeah. You have a little kick round, eh? I'm just going to go and have a word with your mother, yeah?
You know, we'll have to discuss things at some point.
I know.
So,
why don't we sit down and talk about it now?
Right now?
Why not?
So how have you been?
I've been fine.
Great. How's the job?
Yeah, it couldn't be better.
I am pleased for you, Jim.
The doctors are dead pleased. They reckon the last couple of weeks have really come on.
I don't want to change any of that.
What?
But we need to talk about what we're going to do. Divorce and a house. And Will?
Yeah. Well, go on then.
Sorry?
How do you see the future?
Not bad. I can live with that.
You should have the hangover of death.
And you sound like me, Mum. Don't be worrying, I am paying the price. My head is banging.
So how was it then, this girls' night out?
What do you reckon about this? It's my first day at Bev's bar today.
Did that Nisha one get as bladdered as you?
Come on, Jay. What do you think?
It's great.
Thanks. Aren't you one of them fellas that likes a girl in uniform? You know, WPCs, nurses.
Not especially.
Morning, Bev.
Oh, so we'll see the creature from the pits finally resurfaced. Recovered from the mystery illness.
Oh, yes. I feel a lot better now, thanks.
Good. Oh, you can open up by yourself then, can't you, if you're feeling full of beans. Oh, Tatiana spurns cosmetic surgery. Don't make me laugh. She's got eyes like Cat Watson's. Mm.
Flippin' heck.
You all right, Bev?
I feel like I've just seen a ghost. What's with the get-up?
I've chosen new clothing to reflect my new persona.
Oh, very nice.
Thank you.
All right, Jessie, love. How was the honeymoon?
Fantastic.
What have you done with Ray?
He's gone down to Bournemouth to see Kissy.
Ah, tell me,
What was Brussels like? Did you catch sight of any of them bloated Eurocrats going by on the gravy train?
Everybody was very pleasant, actually.
Well, they would be. So would you if you'd taken by stealth what Hitler couldn't take by force?
Well, I better get on. Plenty to do.
I mean, you could tell a city by its attractions, can't you? And what's Brussels got, apart from that little lad having the best?
The mannequin peace fountain, you mean?
Oh, is that what they call it? And we're letting them swallow our sovereignty.
Bye, Ron.
Yeah, ta-ra, Jess.
You didn't get in till 2 last night.
Oh, I'm not allowed.
So we went.
Told ya. Nisha, some of her mates. After closing, we ended up going the Magnet, and Nisha got talking to these fellas.
Yeah?
Yeah. She's got a real nerve here. I mean, if she fancies someone, she'll just walk right over to him and dish it up in his face.
Oh, yeah?
She has a copy for this really fit fella from the uni.
Yeah.
He was like a model. Then he took her back to his place.
Well, obviously, we can't stay living together.
Yeah, obviously. I've been thinking a lot about our relationship. Talking to my counsellor. I've even visited a few mental health websites.
Eh?
On my computer. Some really good sites there. They tell you things the doctors won't or don't want to.
Falling in love with that machine.
You're doing it again.
What?
Anything I'm interested in, you mark it.
It was only a remark.
See, I can't live with you because I can't achieve any sort of balance when you're near me. Even now, you just being here, it shook me up.
I had to come back sometime, Jim.
I know. One of the sites I went on, this woman, she'd had a breakdown, split up from her husband. And she'd written about how it felt. She couldn't build a new version of herself with him around because he knew too much about version one. See, he was part of the past, part of the breakdown.
Well, that's me, is it? I stop you from being new Jimmy.
Because you made old Jimmy the person he was, and old Jimmy made you the person you are. I made a vicious circle for myself.
Maybe. Well, it doesn't matter really now, does it?
Eh?
Well, we can sit here all day picking over the bones of it, but we're still going to get divorced, aren't we? So, let's get down to brass tacks.
Clint! Didn't you get the message?
Look, this is stupid. We've got to start talking again. Especially if you're going to marry Katie.
If I do, it'll be no thanks to you.
I made up you marrying her.
What?
Look, when Jackie told me, it really made me stop and think. Like someone threw cold water in my face. All this business has got so daft, you can't even tell me your plans.
Oh, it is daft. But who started it? Who lied to Jackie about Katie coming on swim?
Please! Look, will you stop walking away from me? Let's have a drink and a talk. Please.
Ah, thanks, Paul.
Enjoy.
Mmm, fantastic. Even if it is only a veggie sausage. You okay?
Yeah. Look, do you mind finishing mine?
What?
Well, if you're that hungry, I'll be back in a while.
Why were you going?
I'm not feeling too good. I'll be all right if you ever lie down.
Why didn't you go and see Nisha?
What?
At the walking centre. That's what it's there for.
No, I just need a couple of pills. I'll see you in a bit.
Hey, your shift starts in 50 minutes, you know, Nick.
Yeah. Oh, it's a bit of a heavy night last night, then.
I reckon you're not the only one. I think Liam's been abducted by aliens and replaced by an android.
What do you mean?
Good morning, Nicky. You look radiant today. Bev, I hope you don't mind, but I've placed some crystals around the bar.
What kind of crystals?
Well, crystals that radiate harmonic energies. In fact, if you don't object, I'd like to hang a couple in the toilet system, you know, just to clear away any negative chi.
You all right, Liam?
Oh, a lot better now, thanks. Can I place the crystals, Bev?
Yeah, whatever you want.
Oh, thank you. You won't regret this.
See what you mean?
And if you post that to your GP surgery, they'll take it from there, OK?
OK, thank you.
Thanks. Hiya, what can I do for you?
I want to know what you're playing at. I wish you'd listen to yourself. You want us to be mates. So I have to forget that you lied. Forget that you lost me my job.
That was an accident. I never realised what I was doing. I'm your brother. Can't I go to your wedding? Oh, come on, Clint. Who else is going to be your best man?
You admit you're dead, then? That's something.
What's that for? Don't you like it? Yeah, it's great. It's just... Well, this is a big change, isn't it?
I read this boss book, right? The Road Less Travelled. Personal growth is a complex, arduous and lifelong task. You need to take an holistic view. Your outer self must mirror your inner self. I showed a negative image to the world, so I attracted negativity from the world.
Nikki, do you want to take the lunch menus out today?
Yeah. Right, lady, what's your game?
Sorry, Bev.
Well, either you're up to something, or that mystery illness of yours has turned your brain into pickled eggs.
I knew you'd think that. You've got to forget the old Leon Powell, Bev. She's gone.
And where's the new one sprung from?
All I want to do is be true to myself and to my friends. There's something I owe you.
What's that, then?
Well, you gave me a chance when I came out of prison. A second chance to be a good person and to help instead of hinder and to change.
So that's what you've done? Changed?
A metamorphosis, yes. I am a butterfly emerging from its chrysalis. And you gave me the chance to change. Thanks for everything, Bev.
We've got to try and make this as easy as possible. For us and for Wills.
I couldn't agree more.
I know you said you wanted him.
Yeah, I still do.
Jimmy, you must know that isn't possible.
Isn't it? Why not?
You know the reasons.
Oh, so am I not a good dad?
Of course you're a good dad.
Right, so I have just as much right to Wills as you have.
Jimmy, you know they always find for the mother in custody
cases. No, not always. So I'm going to try.
You wanted to save yourself needless bother, you said.
This is my son we're talking about. It's no bother looking after him.
Don't get upset.
I'm not. You've just got to understand, I'm going to fight for him.
It'd be pointless, you know. It'd be a waste of time.
Why?
You know why.
You're going to have to spell it out.
Jimmy, come on.
No. You're going to have to say it.
Because of your illness, there's no way they'd let you have him. Jimmy!
Right, run that one by me again.
I heard you had a good night last night.
I did, actually. I suppose Nikki told you.
What do you think you were doing going out with her in the first place?
Ah, hang on. She asked me what I was doing and invited herself along.
Yeah, and you could have said no.
Why?
Nisha, you know quite well why.
Because of what happened between us. You're going to have to explain exactly why that makes a difference. Because I can be friends with whoever I like, and so can she.
Yeah, but you're hardly a friend.
What is your problem? Do you think I was going to get drunk and say, oh, Nikki, your boyfriend's no slouch in the trouser department?
So anyway, how did your night go?
It was okay. I met my mates, we had a few drinks, we had a laugh.
Nikki said that you met up with some guys from uni or something.
I've got work to do.
Oh, no, it's okay, thanks, Seb. I need to face up to my karma sooner or later.
Can I help you?
I'll have an orange juice, please. And...
Darren?
I'll have the same.
Two OJs coming right up. Actually, I know you both have very hectic schedules, but I was just wondering if I could borrow a moment of your time.
What do you want?
I need to apologise.
What?
I want us to forget about the past and just be friends, and I hate to think what I've put you through.
I could have lost my career.
I know, and I'm so sorry. I just hope you can find it in your hearts to forgive me, and we can put the past behind us, and we can live and work side by side in this community. Hi, Anish. Good night last night?
Oh, it wasn't bad, was it? I have to stop drinking on weeknights, though.
I'm sure that was my New Year's resolution. So what was the fella like?
Oh, fair to middling. Like, I could focus at that point anyway.
Oh, you're back quick.
Yeah, I feel much better now. I must have just been sitting there yet.
Right, well, you and Nisha go and find a chair and I'll see you in a minute.
I can't believe you're talking to her again.
Jerome, there's nothing going on between us, which means I can choose whoever I want to be friends with and whoever I want to sleep with.
It's not that.
Then what?
I just think it's weird you and Nick being matey.
Do you think she knows we've slept together?
Of course not. I'm being 6 foot under by now.
Exactly, and she'd hardly want to be my friend, so that, you know.
We mates, then?
Funny how I always end up letting you get away with it.
Well, what else can I say apart from I'm sorry?
You can swear that next time you get the urge to do something that crazy, you do it a long way from me.
Sure. So have you had to ring you?
Not yet. I'm waiting to see what she says first.
She's bound to say yeah.
Do you reckon?
Of course. You get married straight away?
If she wants. I was thinking July or August then.
Sound? Look, I've got an idea. Let's take the girls out to dinner. Do it properly this time. No mad stuff. Especially with you proposing to Katie. Let's try and start again.
Okay. You don't want to hear them?
No, I can't. I've got to pop into town. Good cheers, mate.
Jimmy?
I'm afraid so.
No need to take that tone.
What tone? Thought we were going to be reasonable. Reasonable adults.
We are.
Good. Because I'm going to be every bit as reasonable as you are.
Why did you walk out of here just now then? Is that going to happen every time we try and talk? Because if that's the case, it's pointless.
I walked out because I couldn't believe what I heard you say.
I didn't say anything new.
Excuse me, you did. And you know you did. Because I had to drag it out of you. I had to make you say it.
What are you talking about?
You said I'd never get Will because of my illness.
Think about it, Jimmy. That's only logical. That's not me being spiteful.
Oh, no? Well, pardon me for following my own logic here, but weren't you the one who was so concerned about me? Don't you want me to get better?
Of course I do.
But you say you're going to use the state of my mind against me. You're going to say I'm mentally ill, in open court, in front of everyone. You're going to use my breakdown to take my son away from me.
Flaming hell. It's one of them tomorrow people.
Hello, Mr. Dixon. Hope life's treating you well.
What's that round your neck?
Oh, it's a healing crystal. It helps remove negative vibrations.
It's got its work cut out on you then, hasn't it? I'll have my usual, please, and whatever this young lady would require.
Thanks, Ron. Cappuccino, please. I've been meaning to ask, how did Bridget cope covering for me at Great Granny's?
Have no fear, Jessie. She more than made up for your absence.
Oh, yes.
Hard work oozes from the pores of some people, and she makes it seem effortless, does our Bridget? Moves round the room like a gentle breeze. You look away, you look back. Every surface sparkling. Tell love.
Well, she is new to agency work.
Ah, but that's just it, Jess. You see, if you put your work up against theirs and you ask who was the experienced hand and who was the key novice, well, I'd say it was the other way around.
Do you think she meant it?
It's impossible to tell if she's sincere. I'm beginning to wonder if she's ill.
got your card marked.
Sorry, Beth.
Well, this is just your latest attempt to get your hands on a certain doctor's stethoscope.
What do you mean?
Well, you were as rough as 10 dogs. That didn't work. So you modelled yourself on the girlfriend. That didn't work. And now you've come over all floaty and nice.
Beth, honestly, I'm past all of that. My new persona is for me. But to be honest, certain men can't keep their eyes off me. I can't help it.
I don't want to upset you.
Oh, no, of course not.
I'm just stating the facts. You're putting words into my mouth. I don't want to use your illness against you.
You shouldn't be allowed.
I was diagnosed with bipolar manic depression. You know that. What if I'd been diagnosed with cancer? Or liver failure or something?
It's not the same thing.
You'd never think of using that against me. Oh, Your Honour, please bear in mind, the father of my child's got a dicky liver, so obviously you can't look after him.
Mental health's different.
Why? Ill is ill is ill. I can't see any difference.
Well, the rest of the world can. There's no point you going after Wills, Jimmy. I'm going to get awarded custody and you'll have enough on your plate trying to find somewhere else to live.
Oh, is that right? Well, you can forget that, because there's no way I'm leaving this house.
Jimmy, there's no other way round it. You've got to be reasonable, please.
Oh, yeah. That word again. The grounds for our divorce, which you accepted. Unreasonable behaviour. Your unreasonable behaviour. Yeah, well, if you can stoop so low as to brand in me a nutcase to take my son away from me, I'm going to have to think what I can say about you.
Can I help you, sir?
Yeah. I'd like to see your engagement rings, please.
Certainly, sir.
Oh, yes, Your Honour. My wife slept with another woman while our child slept in the next room.
Jimmy, you can't do that.
Tit for tat. If you can twist the truth about me, I'll do the same back. I could say you're a lesbian. And now you're prepared to use the illness you caused to snatch my child and my home away from me.
Jimmy, will you just listen to yourself?
Yeah, and I'll get our Lindsay to back me up as well. Like she'll need much persuading. Whatever you fire at us, we'll fire something back. We'll knock you so hard you'll never get up.
There's no point raking it all up, Jimmy, because you can't win.
You were right. There's no point any more talking. This is war.
So you know the people from immigration and these character references they need? Well, have you asked anyone yet?
Only Ron.
Why Ron?
Well, he's a respectable businessman.
Yeah, but I thought he'd have turned you down flat.
No, he never. It was weird, actually. Well, suppose I have known him for years. Probably thinks he owes me a few favours.
More like he wants a favour in return, you mean?
Aw, poor Ron. Everyone always thinks the worst of him.
Because he normally deserves it. Oh, I wouldn't trust him an inch. He's bound to want something in return.
I've run off my feet all day. Do you know I give 3 customers the wrong change in half an hour? Just couldn't concentrate. Is your dad about?
He's having us dinner. Oh, there's a Sonny there for you.
Tell. How is he?
You should ask him yourself.
Yeah, well.
You should at least try.
Listen, when I come back from Val's, I thought things might have changed, but the worst of anything. All right.
Nice that, kidda. Really enjoyed it.
What's that? Your shopping list?
Not exactly.
Jimmy's cupboard. Oh, well, very childish, Jimmy. What are we going to do next, eh? Have our own shelves in the fridge, buy our own pints of milk, stick little labels on them.
Jack?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, hey, very nice. Couldn't be splashing out on you, has he? Well, for you, not me. You weren't in when they were delivered. They're off, Robbie. Can I read the note? Thought it was time we all got together. Table for 4, booked in Bev's bar tonight. Tell Casey. Love you loads, Robbie. He's reckon everything's okay between him and Clint again? Let's hope so, eh?
suit ready?
Any shirts?
All set for tonight then, eh?
How come we're going for this meal all of a sudden?
Well, why not? Jackie and Katie are bezzies. Me and you are brothers. We should all be mates together. Not having a go at each other all the time. Especially with the used to off to Spain in 2 weeks.
You off into town?
Now. I'm going to meet you. I'm on the bus. We've got a visit in order for Tim today.
Oh, how's he handling being locked up?
He's doing all right. He lets out soon, though.
Oh, great. Well, that's something for him to look forward to, eh?
Yeah. Max, you won't say anything to me now, will you, or Anna here about me going today? It's just that they don't know, that's all.
No, of course I won't. Look, I'm sure he'll be pleased to see you.
Yeah. Maybe.
Me to remind you about the letter you said you'd write, you know, in support of her and Fred.
It's all ready for her.
Oh, she'll be made up. She'll be with you in a moment. She's just getting the paperwork.
So, what are we saying on these figures then?
Okay, basically, Great Grannies is turning into a charity instead of a business. We need to get new contracts.
What do you suggest?
I don't know, but we've got to do something. We're practically working for nothing at the moment.
Hiya. How you doing?
Fine. Yourselves?
Fine, thanks.
Now, I hear you reckon you can save me some money.
We think we can, yeah.
Sounds good to me. Let's hear it then.
Well, we'd like to talk to you about the contract for all your cleaning work.
Yeah, we think that we might be able to offer you a very competitive price.
Sorry, but I'm happy with the cleaners I've got already.
You'd be interested in saving money, though.
Of course I would.
Well, we're saying that by changing to us, you'll end up with a better finish for a better price, guaranteed.
Guaranteed?
Absolutely.
And from what Ant tells me, you're being well and truly ripped off.
I thought bookkeepers were supposed to keep the client's accounts confidential.
I only mentioned it to Ron in passing.
Yeah, well, forget about all that. Look, if you change to Great Grannies, all the cash that you save could go towards Josh's future.
Or a nice holiday for the two of you. We're talking about lowering your costs by 12 to 15% here.
Well, I might be interested. I'm not saying I am yet, though. I mean, I will have to go away and think about it.
Of course you will. We're not expecting an instant decision.
No, of course not. But at least if you did change over to us, then you'd know that we'd helped you out already, wouldn't you? You know, with your little immigration problem.
Is there really any need for this?
Why not?
How are we going to explain it to Kylie, for the start?
Kids are used to things being labelled in school.
Yeah, well, this is her home, isn't it?
She'll cope.
Look, whatever's going on between us, I really think she should be kept out of this.
Yeah, well, I'm not dragging her into anything.
Well, why have you gone this far, then?
Because if we know what's where and who it belongs to, it'll save us having to talk to each other, won't it?
I was really glad that you sent me the visiting orders. I really wanted to talk to you.
Just paint 1,000 words. Especially topless ones. Will you sit down? Everyone's looking at you.
I went into the office on the way in. Put a fiver in your phone money.
Sound. Thanks. Tom's taking his time with his coffee, isn't he?
I told him not to rush. I thought if you're going to have a go at me, it's best for him not to be here. Didn't want him to see. Tim, I'm sorry, I shamed you in front of all your mates. If that's what you can call them in here.
Just ignore them. You've never ashamed me.
Don't lie. All these new marks I've all seen with no clothes on. I've never done the pictures now. I only done them so you could have a bit of money for when you got out so you could get married.
I liked them.
Did you?
I wish it was me that had taken them. It's the divvy Carl.
Tim, what kill him for what he's done? Made him look like a piece of scum out the gutter. But what
That's what all these in here think of me.
Hey, never mind what anyone else thinks. You're not a piece of scum out the gutter. I know.
Wasn't giving anything away there, was she?
I think we did okay.
I'll have another word on the way out. You know, turn on the Al Dixon charm, like.
Oh, right. Can't wait to see that. Close this one off.
Rob?
It's meant to be on your side. You can't let the immigration people see this.
It won't be. Don't worry about it.
Right. Thanks very much for the coffee. And when you've had a chance to think about your cleaning needs.
What's this meant to be?
What's up with it?
Well, it's supposed to be a good character reference.
Yeah.
Oh, she's fairly normal for a vegetarian.
Well, you know.
She once kept a chicken called Kiev, which she used to let run wild around the house.
You did, though.
Once, Ron, when it escaped, that's all.
Maybe you could have another look at it, love.
There's no maybe about it. Listen to this bit. She used to be a bit wayward in her younger days. Had a few scraps in the street, that type of thing. And this, to be honest, until she met me, she'd had a reputation for being a bit of a slapper.
Ron? I can't believe that.
Lance, go and get some writing paper. Because if you want the cleaning contract for this place, we'd better start from scratch, hadn't we?
I'll leave you to it. I've got other new contracts to find.
I thought you'd eat me.
Why?
For showing everything that I've got.
Hey, I might eat that Carl. But not you.
I just wanted to say I'm sorry, that's all. Just get loads of stick off your mates.
No.
You're just saying that. But they're all calling me a right slag.
They were talking about you, yeah?
I see.
Yeah, but not for being a slag. For being a cracking page three babe.
Are you serious?
Yeah, I had them all dead jealous of me.
Go away.
What do you expect, eh? They all reckon I'm dead lucky for going out with a stunner like you. And I am.
What do you mean that?
Wouldn't say it otherwise.
Can't wait for you to get out of this place.
It's not long until I'm due out now.
Will you still want to marry me now?
You just wait until our wedding, right? Then you'll see how much I want you.
Kind.
Kind.
Considerate.
Considerate.
Thoughtful.
Thoughtful. Oh, and sensitive.
Yeah, all right, I get the message.
Oh, kind to animals as well.
Oh, hang on. Major concern for animal welfare.
Hey, and you're a wonderful mother.
Oh, thank you.
Wonderful mother.
That's more like it, isn't it? Oh, and helping the aged.
Hey, come on now, helping the aged?
Yeah.
When?
Well, you should know. You used to warm your feet on me in bed.
Very funny. Get out of it.
Do you want this cleaning contract or not?
Right, what shall I have for my tea?
Nana, can we all have our own cupboards?
No, love. There's no need for that. You carry on sharing with me and your mummy.
Get yourselves a glass, then.
Hi, Max.
Hi.
No spreading it round like a racing driver.
Joke, I'm not wasting this. But he's ready then.
Something to celebrate.
I wish I knew.
Grab yourself a glass if you want. Join us for the bevy.
No, it's all right. I'm going in a minute.
Oh, come on. You can have a quick one, can't you?
All right. Well, just to be sociable.
So, come on. What is all this champagne and hazel?
Well, Jack, I've always said to myself, the day I know I've met the girl in my dreams, the girl I want to spend the rest of my life with, the girl who want to marry me. And I've always said to myself she'd have a glass of champagne in her hand when she said yes. So say yeah, Jackie. Make me the happiest man in the world. Tell me you'll marry me.
Tim, can you now, leave them to it. I'm not saying no.
Sounds like it to me.
I'm not. You just took me by surprise.
What's the whole idea?
Yeah, but...
Shouldn't have done it, should I?
No, asking me is fine.
But answering me is not, though.
Well, not straight away, no. I mean, we haven't been going on that long, really, have we?
What, as long as you and Nathan?
Nathan has got nothing to do with this. But I can't pretend that I've not been through this before. And after the last time, I know I need to give myself time to think. Time to decide if it's really right for me.
You're right. It's your life. And I wouldn't want you making a mistake by rushing in. I feel too much for that.
Why didn't you tell me what he had planned?
He never said a word to me, honest. Jackie looks a bit shocked.
She's not the only one. I'm just going to the toilet. I'll be back down in a minute.
What have you said?
Well, just had needed time to think.
Was he upset?
Well, he didn't seem too happy.
Why aren't you going to see if he's all right?
Yeah, OK. How about you? Are you OK? Look, I better get going, but if you need anything, just let me know.
Been out the blue for you, was it?
Just a bit. I'm still...
What are you like, hey? All these fellas queuing up to marry you. Never happens to me, does it? Always the bridesmaids, I'll be.
What are you doing? Satisfied now? What are you on about?
You heard. Satisfied.
It's just a dryer. I'm not on about a stupid dryer. I'm on about the fact that you asked Jackie to marry you before I had the chance to ask Katie.
Yeah, well, you shouldn't have been so slow, should you?
Why didn't she say yeah?
All right. Everything okay?
Yeah, not exactly, no. It's like you've had some vandals up here.
Oh, look at that.
It's like that when we come in.
What are some people like, hey?
Sick, aren't they? Look, need that hand fixing it, just give us a shout.
Katie will be wondering where I am.
Oh, you're all right, Sam. I'll ask Jimmy to look at it.
Yeah, whatever. Hang on. Jackie will be wondering where I am.
Mum, Nana's sad, isn't she?
She is a bit, yeah.
And Grandad is.
Oh, they've both been a bit upset recently.
Grandad's got his own cupboard and Nana's not allowed to touch it.
Right, come on. Time for your bath now.
I hate it when they fight.
Bath time now, okay?
Sorry about that.
Kids don't miss a thing, do they?
Right, I'm getting off to work.
Dad.
I'll see you later.
Dad.
Love, I just want to get out before your mother comes back down, OK?
Look, all I want to say is... Look, now it's starting to affect Kylie. Can't you and your mum find a way to move on? Or at least stop being at each other all the time?
That is terrible, though.
That's the trouble with some fellas. Too much testosterone.
Oh, I know some women with the same problem.
Shall I get Jimmy to fix it?
Yeah, if you can. Hey, nothing wrong, did it, do you?
Wrong?
Yeah. Out of revenge for me ripping up his letter?
Could have been.
The cheek of him. What's he calling me, a slapper?
I know. You're an angel. Have you decided whether you're going to give him the new cleaner contract?
Of course I am.
And have you told him?
Go away. No harm in making him sweat a bit, is there?
Love, talk to your mother, eh? Not me. I'm trying to hold on to my last bit of self-respect, dear. And to me house. Your mother wants me out on the streets. And William. She's going round telling everyone I'm a nutcase and shouldn't be allowed to keep him. Can you imagine how that's making me feel? I've been ill, love. You know that. Ill. And she's using it against me. Then now she can sleep at night. She's the one you should be talking to, not me. Oh, and, when you do, tell her the loony sent you.
Is she gonna get off then?
Yeah, we're gonna go back up to the flat.
Give us a chance to have a good talk. Robbie's had to pay with that.
Do you want to order more champagne?
No, no, we're fine, Tom. I'll see you later.
Yeah, I'll see you later.
OK. Do you want to top up?
I've lost the taste for it.
Seems a shame to waste it. You coming up to the flat?
I suppose.
Oh, go on.
You sure you want me to?
Of course I am. Come on, I'll make us a coffee. You OK?
Yeah, I guess.
She's got a nerve, that Bev. I tell you what, if we hadn't wanted that contract off her, I'd have told her where to stick a letter. You all right, love?
Yeah, fine. I just felt a bit hot, that's all. Did you just hear something outside?
Sounded like, didn't it?
Is there anyone out there?
Can't see anyone. Might be next door, though. Maybe even the cat.
Where are you going?
I'm gonna have a look.
Oh, be careful. There could be anyone out there. It could be them lads back.
Anyone there?
As if they're gonna say yes.
Hello? You go back inside, love.
Only as long as you come straight back in after me.
Ring up your memo before you're going to resort your phone money off. Tell me what?
Nothing. I've just been thinking, that's all, since you left. This car fella, you think he'll try and come round and see her again while I'm locked up in here? Will you tell him he's going to be getting a little visit from me, okay? No, don't worry about it. I've been here long enough now and learned a few things. I won't be getting any trouble sorting him out.
But I couldn't stand losing you again. That's all I'm saying. Okay then. I love you, Tim. I really love you.
I'm not taking sides. It's the fact that he's been ill. He thinks you're using that against him.
As if.
Please tell me you said he'd never get Wills because he's been ill.
You know full well he couldn't cope.
And that you're not going to let him stay on in the house.
I'll be bringing William up on my own. Where does he expect us to go? Hey, some crummy bed, sis.
Well, what about him? Where'd you expect him to go?
It's him who wants the divorce, so tough. He'll have to live with the consequences.
And that's it.
What else do you expect me to do?
Well, how about accepting the fact that you're to blame in all of this?
Oh, and there's me thinking you weren't taking sides.
Don't try and talk your way out of it. You're just going to use the fact that he's ill to take his son away from him.
Did you really not know he was going to propose?
Didn't know a thing.
Poor Jackie, eh? The mad thing is, she really likes him. Probably enough to marry him in the end.
She wouldn't want to marry him, you know. Not if she knew what he was really like.
What do you mean?
Nothing. I shouldn't have said anything.
Clint, Jackie's my best mate. If there's something to know, she should know it.
He loses his head.
Don't we all?
Bad style sometimes.
How bad?
I'm just now upstairs, kicking doors, smashed the dryer off the wall.
Well, he was upset.
You know me and him had to get off to Spain. It was after he started the scrap with that lad. I'm really sorry, I know I should have told you all this ages ago.
So he started a fight. It happens.
Robbie lost his head totally. He glassed the lad he was fighting. 40 stitches he needed. And he lost an eye and all.
I should have listened to Nisha, shouldn't I? She tried to warn me and I wouldn't listen.
Jackie wouldn't want to marry him, would she? Not if she knew what he was really like.
I'm just not having you.
to rob you of something with no proof, or trying to turn me against them for your own reasons.
Are things okay between you two?
Yeah, no problem, Ray, no problemo.
Have a good night.
Looks like Nikki's gonna be the life and soul.
Hey, you. Say nothing.
The next visit of Rookie is Friday night at 8:30 here on 4. Now, up next, a doctor in denial faces something truly terrifying, losing all things that come so naturally to you and I. Life in the ER won't get any tougher than this.
Fair enough. See you later.
Is Jackie in the flat?
She was 2 minutes ago. Did you give her a message after?
No, I'll see her when I see her. It wasn't important.
Okay, so on a Tuesday after Bridget's finished Mrs. Davis, could she fit in Mrs. Kane, do you think? She wants her bedrooms done as well as the downstairs.
All before dinner?
I know it'd be tight.
Certainly would.
Maybe it'd be too much for her.
I don't know. Just can't get the staff these days, can you?
I'm not surprised the peanuts you pay.
Peanuts? Minimum wage? Thank you very much.
With the emphasis on the word minimum.
Oh, it is the industry standard.
Well, it's still peanuts regardless.
Whose side are you on?
I'm on the side of the poor and the oppressed.
Oh, good. I am pleased, because that includes me and Anthea as well. You haven't seen the profit margins we've been working on lately.
What margin? So, what do you think?
Well, I don't know, love. You'll have to ask Bridget herself. I don't know how fast she can dust. Don't want to give her a heart attack, do we?
Do you know what? It sounds like you want to put her out to grass and get yourself a younger model. And if they were under 21, you'd pay them even less.
Hey, hang on. I don't only think about the bottom line, you know. That was the whole idea of the great grannies in the first place. To employ staff who had a bit of experience. People with maturity and quality.
Yeah, people who'd work for less money.
Don't be at it, Michael. This isn't all just about pounds, shillings and pence. Because if it was, do you know who'd be on the books then? All them under 21s we could be paying even less to.
I'm surprised you haven't dropped the idea of great grannies ages ago. Do you know what it should be called now, Anthea? Great granddaughters. You'd save yourself a fortune.
Raimondo! Keeping yourself busy there, kid.
Yeah, keeping the place tidy, you know.
Nice one, yeah. Hey, listen, I've been wondering how you've been, you know, since the dickos were robbed.
Well, it's on pins, to be honest, you know. I feel as though I should have eyes in the back of my head, you know?
Yeah, well, you need them, don't you?
Jessie's just the same, you know? Some days she's scared to go out.
Tragic, that. Listen, I believe your mother was shook up.
Yeah, she was in a heck of a state. Mind you, the doctors were very, very good with her. She's getting better, bit by bit.
Been that bad?
Oh, yeah. Her blood pressure was sky high. You know, she collapsed twice. It really knocked her about.
Thought I hadn't seen her around.
No, she's staying with me, brother. She's too scared to stay around here.
Well, you can't blame her, can you?
Oh, it's too close to where it happened.
Makes you think.
It certainly does. These young fellas, they get into drinking drugs. They don't care how they pay for them. And they don't give a thought for the victims.
Steady on. Your blood pressure will be going off the scale.
Oh, yeah. I'm sorry. But it just gets to me, you know.
Sounds like you need something to take your mind off it. Hey, I'll tell you what. You come over to ours. I'll show you my latest project.
Oh. Well, I don't think I'm into another arch, Jim.
Arch? Me eye. No, it's the internet.
Oh, right.
Yeah, I'm well into it. Got all the gear set up in the extension.
Oh, well, I wouldn't mind taking a look at that sometime.
Of course you can have a look. You'd love it. Hey, I tell you what, I'll go and get the kettle on, eh? Yeah, and get it booted up, ready? Come on.
Assuming you're working tonight?
Nope. Quite fancy night out, don't you?
Can't. The essay's due in tomorrow.
Oh, poor diddums.
Well, you can always stay in and help me with it if you want.
Go away, on my night off. Now, I could have a word with Nisha, though. She'll be going out with her mate tonight, so I could see if she'd mind me tagging along again.
Ah! Is he ready for me?
Sorry?
Jimmy, he said he wanted to show me his new computer.
All right.
He sounds really into it, doesn't he?
Yeah, I think he is. You'll have to excuse me, Ray. I need to catch the post.
Oh, no bother. It must be a relief to you, you know, to have Jimmy having a real hobby again. I mean, no more of these silly boards, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I do. It keeps him occupied, you know, and I hardly see him, Ray. I'll see you.
Are you all right, love?
Yeah, I'm fine. I'm just not into computers, that's all.
I'm really sorry for spoiling the night.
Don't be soft.
I was just so shocked.
I don't blame you.
You had a late one.
Yeah, we just sat in the bar talking. Thought you might need some time together. So what happened when you came back up?
Robbie just went straight to bed.
He didn't even talk.
Well, I tried, but I didn't want to push him. He said he wasn't in the mood.
What did you talk this morning?
A few grunts, that's all, to be honest. He made me feel dead guilty. Really is his feelings, haven't I?
But you shouldn't feel guilty. I mean, if you're not completely sure about marrying him, then you'd be mad to say yeah.
No, it's not that I'm not sure, end of story. I just didn't want to give him an answer on the spot. I did that with Nathan, and look how that turned out.
So you still think you might say yeah?
Yeah, of course. And why do you say it like you've got some big doubts?
Maybe because I have.
Like?
I don't know if it's my business to say.
Say what?
I'm just dead weary after Nathan, that's all. You'll just think I'm interfering again.
Oh, get out of it. Katie, we came through that all right. And whatever doubt you've got this time can't be half as bad as then, can they?
You see, out there in cyberspace, Ray, you've got a million new worlds waiting for you. All at the touch of a button.
Tremendous. I saw Jackie before.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I see this when I click on there, look.
She's not too keen on you being in here all the time.
Look, you know what she's like. Look at that. A few seconds and we'll be inside a museum in New York. Can you believe that?
It's amazing. Are things okay between you two?
Yeah, no problem, Ray. No problemo.
It's good to hear that. But I'd I thought you'd been going through a bad patch in that. Well, I was just a bit worried for you.
Ray, it's not a bad patch. We're getting divorced. So, when you think about it, that's a good thing, isn't it? Shows we're ready to move on.
Fair enough. I just thought you might be a bit down, that's all.
Totally the opposite, Raimundo. I only wish we'd done it years ago.
Hi.
What can I get you?
Oh, a mug full of caffeine, please. I need something to liven me up.
You're still hungover this time of day, are you?
Just knackered. Started watching a video at midnight and knew it was a mistake.
Where's your stamina?
Oh, wish I knew. Due out tonight as well.
Oh, yeah? Yeah, it's a nice house, is it?
Unless you pick up some poor, unsuspecting lads.
Could do with a nice house yourself.
Aren't you working?
No. I was just saying to Jerome before. Quite fancy a nice house.
Hi.
What's that?
Yeah.
So you're taking Nicky out, then?
Yeah, well, he's got a big essay he's got to get done, haven't you?
Yeah, it's due in tomorrow.
Not gonna stay in with him and help him with it?
I mean, night off. Much rather be out enjoying myself somewhere.
I think Austrian is shoes free.
As if. You can't drag it away from Steve these days. What about me taking along with you all tonight?
Yeah, why not? If you're desperate.
Okay, great, Tom. We had a good night last week, didn't we?
Excellent. Yeah.
Go ahead, click on home. Home! See? Takes you back to where you started.
It's unbelievable, really, isn't it? I mean, I've seen loads of it on things on the telly and that, but it's all a .com or www nowadays, isn't it?
Yeah, well, it's the future, mate. The future. Hey, and it shouldn't just be for youngsters either. No, it's for everyone. Victoria's been helping me, you know. Yeah, I'm going to create my own homepage with her help.
Oh, very nice.
Only me.
Oh, hiya. You should see what Jimmy's got me doing in here.
Sorry, Ray, I'm a bit busy at the minute.
Oh, right, sorry.
Yeah, Ray, look at this.
Best get on.
Yeah, sure.
Good, this, innit?
Yes, very interesting.
Got loads more sights I could show you, eh? Hey, tell you what, you could have a bite to eat with me while we surf.
Well, I don't want to put Jackie to any trouble, you know.
It's got nothing to do with Jackie. You're my guest, not hers.
I've never seen Ken so, well, so wound up before.
But why is he suddenly saying all this about Robbie, though?
Because he thinks he should.
And he reckons that Robbie glassed this lad?
Yeah. 40 stitches, and he lost his eye.
Robbie would never do anything like that.
Well, I was as shocked as you. That's why they had to get off to Spain the first time, because this lad's family were after him and the lad's mates.
Well, that's not what they told us.
Well, you can see why, can't you? It wouldn't be the world's best chat-up line I made in Spain because I glassed someone in a fight.
Well, I'm sorry, Casey, but I don't believe it. I mean, the way we are with each other now, he'd have told me something like that, I know he would.
Well, would you have forgiven him if he had and just got on with your lives?
Well, I'm not even going to answer that.
Why not?
Because I don't believe he'd have done it in the first place.
Great-granddaughters hasn't got quite the same ring as great-grannies.
Good way of saving money, though.
It's the law of the land, Michael. The government say under 21s can be paid less, not us.
Will we get the same quality of work, though, from a bunch of school leavers?
Well, why not, if we train them properly?
Yeah, but that was the whole idea of going for the great-granny angle in the first place, wasn't it? There'd be women with a lifetime of cleaning behind them.
Well, all I'm saying is it's the kind of option we might have to look at. And if we want to improve our profit margin, we might not have any choice. Business, remember, not charity.
I thought you were the last of the great capitalists.
Jimmy's cupboard? What's up? Are you getting forgetful in your old age?
No, it's my little statement there, you know. A little declaration of independence. Well, I had to do something, didn't I, you know, with a certain person wanting me out on the streets, not wanting me to know my own son, telling everyone I'm not a fit father because of my mental state. Can you believe anyone would do that, mate, eh? Never mind my own wife. Been expecting her to send the men in white coats in with straight jackets. Butter on your bread, Ray.
I'm only telling you what Clint told me.
Well, for whatever reason, Clint has got to be lying to you.
I don't think he is.
And I don't think Robbie's been lying to me.
Maybe he hasn't. It's what he hasn't told you, though.
All right, yeah. Right, maybe there was some fight. Clint's probably just exaggerating about Robbie.
But why would he do that?
Or maybe you are.
Me? Why would I do that?
I don't know. After the way you had that big downer on Nathan, how do I know that you're not just going through the same sort of stuff now?
What stuff?
Trying to stop me settling down with a fella again. I mean, I know we're mates, Katie, but I am entitled to go my own way.
Jackie, don't start going off on one.
I'm not. I'm just not having you accusing Robbie of something with no proof, or trying to turn me against him for your own reasons.
Don't be at it, Jackie. You're my best mate. If Clint had glassed someone, I'd want you to tell me, because it might be me next.
Well, you're the one who's at it. And whatever it is has made you lie about Robbie. Well, I've heard enough, all right? And look, if you have got a problem me being with Robbie, maybe you should pack your bags and get off with Clint. At least then I wouldn't have to listen to your jealous lies.
You sure you don't mind us popping out?
Of course not.
We'll only be an hour. Have a drink, see if you can see Bev. Twist her arm a bit more about this contract.
Dad, I'll be fine. Go on.
Was that Rachel that phoned?
Yeah, she sends her love.
How's her mum?
Yeah, fine by the sounds of it. Beth was a bit grisly after the journey down there, but...
She's every right to be. Bristol's a long way.
Yeah, they'll be fine. The break will do the pair of them good.
You right, then?
Oh, I am, if you are.
You can always give us a ring if you need anything.
A bit of peace is all I need. Just go on, will you?
Thought you were going straight home after college.
Yeah, well, I thought I'd come and have a drink with you before you went out.
Oh, I didn't want to be left all on your lonesome.
Well, I've got my essay to keep me company.
You think I look nice?
Yeah, you look great.
Does make the effort. Nisha always looks gorgeous when she's glammed up. Don't you reckon?
You know, I've never really thought about it. You say nothing, okay? Not a single word.
Did you find Clint?
Nah, I missed him. She Katie?
Yeah, she's in a room.
What's the problem?
She starts a bad mouth on you. But I wouldn't worry about her because she's off her head.
Why, what did she say?
Do you know what? I can't even bother telling you. I reckon Clint's been winding her up, that's all.
Well, what's he been saying, though?
Some mad reason that you'd had to get off to Spain.
Like what?
Apparently, you're supposed to have glassed some lad. Lost him his eye.
Clint told Katie that.
From what I can gather, yeah. And she believed him.
So you're having off the reds.
Did you enjoy that, kid?
It's very nice, thanks, yeah.
Another hour on the internet?
No, I think I'd better be making a move.
I don't have to get going, do you?
Yeah, well, I don't like leaving Jessie on her own for too long, you know. I mean, I'll just give you a quick hand with these dishes, eh?
Leave them, mate.
Well, it won't take a minute.
Ray, I'll do them in my own good time, OK?
Well, you know what Jackie's like. She's a stickler for cleanliness.
Kid, get the message, will you? Jackie's got no say in nothing anymore in this house, right?
Right, right. I'll make a move then. I'll get me coat.
All right, kid, see ya.
Will you just tell me what you want? I don't know. Yet. Look, there's no cash here, you know.
There'll be something.
And my dad'll be back any minute. Shut up! Whinging, will ya?
Come on, girls. The cab's got the meter running. Down in one egg. You have to be quick. Just watch us. Thought you had an essay to do.
Yeah, I'm on my way home now. Have a good night.
Looks like Nicky's gonna be the life and soul.
I guess I'll see you when I see you then, yeah?
If you get back in one piece. Hey, Glenn, don't you be working too hard.
How come you mate with Nisha all of a sudden?
I told you, she's a good laugh. You know, I'm dead well together.
Nicky, are you coming or what?
Yeah, come on, hurry up. Why? You're getting all coffee because I'm going out. We've got not to worry about, you know. I mean, we both know what Nisha's like when she's out. No man's safe, are they? Just because she's like that doesn't mean I'm the same.
Come on.
Right, I'll let her go.
Yeah, go on.
See you later. Good luck with the essay.
I heard the door go. Is Ray gone?
That's right.
Oh! I'm choking here.
You what?
I'm choking. I can have some water, please.
No. No way. I'm gonna take you for a little spin first till you tell me where the cash is.
Woo!
What are you doing?
Woo!
What are you doing?
Woo!
Can you do wheelies in this, boy?
You what?
Come on, then. Give us a go. Shut it, will you? Well, I'll shut it for you.
Typical Bev. She's not going to turn up, is she?
She did promise she'd be here to sign the contract.
Should we pack up and go home?
Oh, we can wait another half an hour.
I feel bad about leaving our Michael on his own, though.
No, you heard what he said. He doesn't want us fussing round after him. He's desperate to get a bit of his independence back.
Ah, yeah.
I hope you're going to clear this mess up.
You what?
Look at the state of this place. You made more of a mess than our William.
How that, yeah.
So you're going to clear us up or what?
When I'm ready, yeah.
Oh, and when might that be?
In the morning, probably.
Tomorrow morning? Jimmy, I am not living with filth like that.
I've said I'll do it.
I'm talking about today. Jimmy, I've been patient. I waited till Ray went, and now I want to make myself some tea.
Leave it, will you? It's my mess, and I'm the one who's going to clean it up, OK? when I'm good and ready. And if you don't like it, you know where the door is.
Oh, I see. Like that, is it? Well, it isn't gonna work, Jimmy. You can play all the sad and twisted games that you like, but I am telling you this now, there is no way that you're gonna force me out of this house. No way! Not in a million years.
I'm sorry I couldn't say yet straight away.
No worries. It's a big decision. I respect you for it.
I mean, I haven't gone off you or anything, you know.
I don't want to talk about it.
What do you want to talk about then?
I don't want to talk at all. I want to take you to bed.
Yeah, but why do you think your Clint would say something so mad about you?
I said I don't want to talk about it.
Well, I honestly didn't believe a word of it, you know. And I haven't got a clue why Katie went along with it.
I'm so proud you stood by me, you know, Jack. You mean the world to me. I really love you. No matter how long it takes you to say yeah, I'll be here for you. Because I can't live without you. I need you more than anything in the world. More than anything.
What is it that you want?
Ketchup.
What?
Ketchup.
What are you going on about?
Your mate, Robbie.
Robbie Moffat? Well, what about him?
Tell him I was here. Okay.
Just get off me, buddy.
Tell Robbie Moffat. Tell him Ricky Garner was here.
How do you know Robbie?
Because Robbie tells me things. Like where to go when I need cash. Like which house has got a big wad waiting to be robbed. Like the art fella in this place.
You robbed me, Dad.
Only because Robbie Moffat told me to. See ya.
I know we did it.
What? What's going on?
Bev called last order, so I've invited everyone back.
You think I did it as well?
How?
It's too late, Jack. You've given yourself away.
I know you would never do anything like that.
It's a long time since I've been with anyone else. I might be a bit out of practice.
I don't mind.
And that next Brookside is an hour-long episode on Wednesday at 8 o'clock, and next Friday's Brookie moves to 8 as well. Well, next on 4, Monica and Chandler are about to be rumbled. We'll be right back.
Well, we should have stayed for one more.
Oh, I can't wait to get these shoes off. My feet are killing me.
Hey, come here, you.
What are you doing? Ron!
Listen, do you remember all them years ago we were caught and I used to give you them knee tremblers down the back out?
I forgot about that.
Yeah, well, do you fancy one now?
Oh, a knee trembler. You'll have to catch me first.
You what?
Last one back fills the hot water bottle.
Anthony, come here. Come here. What?
Your mic's only in there.
Tell you what, I'll warm the bed up. You put the kettle on.
Ron!
Auntie, I'm all right.
Ron!
Oh, thought you'd be in bed.
I'm just going.
Yeah? Come on, everybody in.
Hey.
Come on, I'm gonna move on.
Hi, Jackie.
What's going on?
Bev called last order, so I've invited everyone back.
What?
Come on, you.
Hiya, cuz. Oh, what are you doing in your house, cuz? We're having a party.
Right. I'm phoning the ambulance.
No, Dad, there's no need.
Michael, just let him check it out, son.
Dad's right.
Look, I'm all right. I can feel everything. I can move my toes. If there was something wrong with me, I'd know. Don, can you put me back in my chair, please?
If I could just get my hands on that evil bloody get did this.
Yeah, well, it could have been worse. You could have been here. Oh, Rachel.
Put your arm around my shoulder, son. You ready on the count of three? One, two, three.
You okay?
Yeah.
No pain anywhere?
No, I'm all right.
I'll get you a new top.
Thanks. You all right? What's the world coming to, eh? And you're not even safe in your own house. What the hell's happened?
This really isn't my scene.
No, it's not mine either.
I'd rather be curled up with a good book.
Yeah, I would.
Probably go once I finish this.
Oh, no, don't get off. We hardly ever have time to talk.
I'm sorry.
I'm just so happy that we're best friends. I'll get you another drink, won't be a sec.
What are you playing at?
What?
Bringing a load of bloody strangers back to the house.
They're not strangers, they're mates.
Do you mind?
Get them out, Jimmy.
No.
I mean it, Jimmy. Get them out of my house.
Why? Lindsay and the kids are the pals. I'm not disturbing anyone.
You're way out of order, Jimmy.
Wait! Who's ready for the baby?
Jimmy! I've got D-I-V-O-R-C-E!
I thought it was blood. I just saw you lying there out the chair.
He was off his head.
The scum, you bloody scum. Anyone who breaks it to someone else and does something like that is the worst than scum.
Dad, would you listen? I know who did it.
What?
I know who's behind the burglaries.
Who?
It's Robbie.
Sorry.
Get on the phone.
Let's just hang fire for a minute.
Anthea, will you get on the phone? I want our Jackie and a thieving boyfriend round here now.
We don't know for certain it was him.
Well, why would he lie?
Look, the lad gave our Michael his name, didn't he? What more proof do you want?
Right, then we wait for the police to come and let them deal with it.
Michael, you ring her. Tell our Jacqueline I want a word with her now and don't take no for an answer.
Ron, this is...
Now!
This one is for peace and harmony. Well, I think it's for peace and harmony.
Well, if you're not sure, how do you know if it's working?
Oh, you can tell. My karma is buzzing. I'm at one with the world. Ow! Which way you going, will you, Tibby? Right, what was I saying?
About how you're a changed woman.
Oh, yeah, right. I feel like I've been reborn.
Yeah. You having a drink?
Just finished one.
Have another.
Oh, you trying to get me drunk?
What is it? Brandy and baby sham.
Hey, don't get away with it that easy.
What I really want is to get educated, you know, like you. I want to make something of myself.
Oh, you mean like do a course?
Well, why would I want to do that? I don't need a course, not when I've got you to teach me.
Will you listen to yourself? He's a 25-year-old lad. He'll make mincemeat out of you.
Here he come now.
I mean it, Ron. First sign of trouble, I'm getting back onto the police. Just keep calm, right? Don't make any wild accusations.
Hi, Aunt. What's happened?
Me and your dad weren't here. We went round to Bev's for a drink.
Bloody hell.
Don't be acting like you're shocked, you Robin Gett.
Dad?
You think we don't know what you've been up to, eh?
What are you doing?
He deserves everything he gets.
Will you leave it?
What's up with you?
We know.
Know what?
That he is behind the burglaries.
What?
Yeah, your fella there. He's a thief. He's robbed us blind.
Oh, so you believe some lying little druggie over your own sister?
No, it's him I don't believe. Say hello to Robbie, he said, like he was his bezzy mate.
He didn't do it.
So how come the lad knew him then? Come on, answer me that.
I'm phoning the police.
No, don't do that.
They'll sort it.
No! There's no need. I'll come clean. I do know the lad. His name's Ricky.
Hey, get out of my house, you.
I beat him up. After he's got done the other week, I asked round a bit. Found out who did it, and I jumped him. I thought it was time someone taught him a lesson.
For God's sake, Robbie.
Well, he deserved it.
He could have ended up dead.
So you know where he lives, then?
No. I collared him outside the pub.
You should have gone to the police.
That still doesn't explain how he knew about the money.
What money?
Me dad's dosh. He reckons you told him it was in the house, that's why he came to rob the place.
I don't know anything about that.
Yeah, well, nobody else apart from us knew the cash was in the house.
Well, if you don't believe me, ask our Clint. He'll back me up. I had nothing to do with it.
Dad, he beat the lads up. What more do you want?
I just want to know how he knew about the money.
Someone must have told him.
Are you saying he's lying? Right, that's it. We're going.
I never did it, Jack. Honest.
I know you didn't. And I think it's a disgrace. How dare you accuse Robbie of something when the only thing he's guilty of is trying to protect you?
They're only trying to get to the bottom of what happened.
Well, you can get to the bottom of this. If you don't trust Robbie, then he won't come round here anymore, right? And neither will I.
Jackie.
See, he's round.
Jackie, hang on!
Yes, so am I. Sorry about your two-faced, hypocritical, two-bit snob family.
What?
Looking down the nose at me like I'm some sort of scum.
Hang on, the lad did give your name in.
So what?
So you can't blame them for kicking off.
Why, she? You're on their side, aren't you? You think I did it as well?
No.
It's too late, Jack. You've given yourself away.
I know you would never do anything like that.
You're all the same, you Dixons, aren't you? Always waiting to have a pop. Just because I haven't got the big house in London, the flashy car.
Oh, don't be stupid.
Don't call me stupid!
Robbie, please. Look, I don't want us to fall out over this. Look, I'm on your side.
I know why you won't marry me. Because I haven't got the big stash in the bank like the other fella had. Go on, go back to your Mike and your dad. Go on, slag me off a bit more!
What's going on? Okay.
So you designed this?
Yeah.
And then you put it onto Jimmy's computer?
No, it's on everybody's computer.
What, everyone in the whole of England?
No, everyone in the whole world.
Everyone in the whole world? Oh, you are joking. How long did that take you?
So she's off out with the girls, then?
Yeah.
No wonder your face is dripping, yeah? Be like bees round honey, mate.
I'm not bothered.
Oh, like that, is it?
Yeah, well, I can take it or leave it at the moment.
Best way to be, mate. Get you involved, you only mess it up.
Hey, come on, Tiger.
Jack?
Ricky?
Look, the birds said to find you here. Thought to come and surprise you.
Well, I was just going to go.
Well, he's an ass to go now.
How come you back so early?
I was missing you. Have a lager, please.
You shouldn't have just accused him like
Hang
that.
Hang on a sec, Auntie. I get attacked by some smacker who says he's Robbie's best mate, and you expect me to forget all about it?
I'm just thinking about Jackie, that's all.
Yeah, but she's made it clear whose side she's on, isn't she?
Maybe she's right. Maybe he is innocent.
Or not. If our Jacqueline wants to choose some thieving no-mark over her own flesh and blood, then that's up to her.
Don't be getting yourself het up.
Het up? That's the understatement of the century. This is our home. We're supposed to feel safe here. Not terrorised week in and week out, scared to answer the bloody door.
I'm not going to let them scare me.
How am I meant to protect my family against low-life scum like that, eh?
Come on. It's over now.
Till next time.
There won't be a next time.
Yeah, well, I tell you now. If there is, I'm going to be waiting for them.
And what good will that do?
Don't you worry. They won't do this to the Dixons again.
Thanks, Max.
After all that you've done for me, if I can't give you tea and sympathy...
I know, but I feel really embarrassed, shouting all over the close like that.
Don't be daft.
I don't even know where to start.
Well, you'll sort things out.
I hope so.
Well, it's serious, then, between you and Robbie, even though you've turned down his proposal.
Well, I love him and everything, but I think it's just a bit too soon for that.
Well, if he's any sense, he'll wait. You're worth it.
Right, I better go. It's getting late.
Yeah.
Give Harry and Emma a big kiss from me.
I will.
And I'm sorry I made such a show of myself.
I really do hope things work out.
Thanks.
It's way past my bedtime.
No, don't go. Just stay another half hour. There's things that I need to ask you.
Like what?
Well,
Why, Leanne?
Well, do you want me to call around tomorrow morning?
No.
Tomorrow night?
I'm out.
Well, maybe Saturday. I like that. Best buddies.
So how many have you had?
Dunno.
Lucy drunk as well, was she?
Yeah, we all were.
So did she come?
Yeah. He was all over her like a rash.
She sounds like a right goer.
Yeah, well, it's not so weird, isn't it? She's got no tags.
She's a slug.
Sorry, love, no can do.
Oh, why else would you, Jimmy? Oh, don't be such a killjoy.
Don't you stop.
Believe you's a splitting up.
We don't know what's happening.
Are you going to move in with your girlfriend?
I'm not even going to answer that. I am made up that Jimmy's finally binned you off at last.
I've been after him for years. Ever since I had me Aunt Dallas Keks at our Amber's wedding.
Well, you can have it. A little bit of Monica
in my life. A little bit of Eric. Hey, come on, Jimmy Coghill. We're playing awesome.
Don't break it.
Where have you been?
Got a walk.
Max Farnham's?
No.
I've been wondering what to say to you when you came in.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
It's all right.
No, I am. I just got browned off because your dad and Mike had a pop at me. Don't want to fall out with you, Jack. I'm really sorry.
There's no need to bite my head off.
I know. I shouldn't have taken it out on you. Next time I go off on one for no reason, just ignore me.
Hiya. Hiya. How is everyone? All right. Did they go, did they? No, they never do, do they?
Going to bed. Come on.
Yeah. Jackie. Come here, hang on a minute.
I need a quick word. In private.
Should we get off?
I've only just got here.
Yeah, well, it's hardly Rave City, is it? I'm walled up with brains.
So is it separate bedrooms now, Jimmy?
Yeah. Has been for a while.
Great.
I can bring you a light back.
Oh. Do you fancy showing me a train set?
Yeah. Why not?
Look, I'll see you back at ours.
Well, hang on, I'll come with you. Just let me finish my drink.
Nicky, you want to go home?
Jerome, hang on, will ya? About before. Look, Katie, I really don't want to hear it. I think we should talk about it. Clear the air. What is this to talk about? I mean, it's pretty obvious that you, me dad and our Mike have got a big downer on Robbie. And to be honest with you, I am getting fed up of listening to yous all slag him off.
We're worried about you, that's all.
You're worried about me? Why? Robbie's sound, he's not a psycho. And he doesn't go round breaking into people's houses.
What? Do you think he did it?
Oh, they made a big deal out of nothing.
Well, have they got any proof?
No, because he wasn't involved.
Jackie, he is bad news.
Oh, do you know what, Katie? Forget it. I'm not going to argue with you anymore.
He's off his head. Even his brothers admitted it.
He had nothing to do with robbing the house.
Jackie, just watch yourself.
Why? In case I actually do manage to get married and be happy and leave you on your own.
What are you on about? I'm getting off to Spain in a fortnight.
You've come between me and fellas before. But I'm not going to let it happen, not this time. Because me and Robbie are happy, right? And we're going to stay happy, no matter what everyone says.
Oh, do you know how long I've waited for this?
We go back a long way, don't we?
Oh, you're not kidding. I always thought you could do better than our Jackie.
It's funny. Copping off. Taking women home. Used to be like changing socks for me. I know I was married to Jackie, but, well, that never stopped me. I was on with all kinds. Seems like another life now. It's a long time since I've been with anyone else. Things have been lately. Jack and me haven't exactly seen eye to eye. So, I might be a bit out of practice.
I don't mind.
You're one hell of a woman, Cheryl. And there's nothing I'd like better for you and me to get it together after all these years.
But...
Well, I don't know if I'm ready.
Then we won't do it.
I don't want you to feel that I've led you home.
Hey, you just make sure it's me that you come to when you're all ready. Hey?
Yeah. Yeah, I will. Do you mind if we just lie here for a bit?
No. That'd be great.
You locked everywhere up?
Yeah.
Come on, get into bed, it's late.
I'm just kidding myself, aren't I?
What about?
All that stuff I was spouting before. Saying I was going to take on anyone who broke in here. I'd be as much use as a chocolate fire guard.
Ron, come to bed.
Can't even protect my own family. God, I'm useless.
Come on.
Have you been?
Brushing my teeth.
For what? 20 minutes? Yeah. What's up with you?
I'm just knackered.
It's all right. You haven't got to do anything. Just lie back. Think of England.
No, Nicky, I'm really tired.
You knocking me back?
You don't mind, do you?
No. As if.
See you in the morning.
Yeah. Night. I'm fed up with everyone slagging it off.
Katie's never liked me.
No.
You know, Mike's always been a bit weird too.
Do you reckon?
Yeah, he looks down his nose at me. Just because he hasn't been to college and got some sort of degree.
What difference does that make?
A lot to him.
Well, it doesn't to me.
Hey, Jack. You don't think I did have anything to do with robbing your dad's house, do you?
Do you think I'd be lying in bed with you now if I thought you did?
Just everyone's trying to turn you against me.
Well, I don't care what any of them say, because I love you. And if they don't like it, they know I'm going to get knotted.
Do you?
Do I what?
Love me?
Yeah.
And then why won't you marry me?
Maybe I should.
What?
Well, that'll prove to everyone how serious we are.
Do you really mean it?
Yeah. I love you. And I want us to get married.
I'm gonna say.
What are you doing?
Give us your hand.
You kept it?
Of course I did. What's gonna give up that easy?
Oh, it's lovely.
Get these people out of my house.
What?
Get them out!
Hiya.
Morning.
What time is it? Oh.
Do you want a brew?
No, I've got to get up now.
Nicky, I'm sorry.
For
last night.
It's no big deal. I can take rejection. I'll just go and kill myself later.
I don't know what was up. I mean, I was out of the game. I just wanted to get my head down. Nick, it had nothing to do with you.
Like I said, it's no big deal. I hadn't even thought twice about it.
Put the kettle on, eh?
Okay.
Can you do that somewhere else?
Finish now.
Dad, I don't want this.
Just get it down, you auntie. Hey, see the racket out the next door last night?
Yeah.
I heard music at 5 o'clock in the bleeding morning. I'm gonna have a word.
Mike, you weren't invited.
Ah, very funny. Where do you go?
Work.
In a shirt and tie? You're a mechanic?
I'm meeting Tina's dad for some lunch.
Oh, aye. Sunday best job, is it?
No.
Hey, you want to keep well in with him? And when you got your big house on the Whittle, me and your mum are going to move into the granny flat.
Will you lay off? Just give me a job, big wow. Where you're going on, you'd think I'd won the pools.
As far as I'm concerned, son, you have.
I'm getting off. I'll see you later.
Give my regards to Daddy. Are you going to eat that or what?
I feel sick.
Again? Give me someone to take you off our hands.
One egg or two, hubby?
Two, please.
With or without beans?
With. I could get used to this.
Well, don't. It's strictly a one-off, and I'm expecting exactly the same tomorrow morning.
Shouldn't you be gone by now?
Doesn't matter if I'm a bit late. Got a good excuse, haven't I?
Well, how long are you going to be?
A couple of hours. Just got to get some of the overtime sheets done.
And you going round to your dad's?
No. I don't know. I don't particularly want to after yesterday.
Yeah, but you've got something to tell them now, though, haven't you?
Yeah, well, I think I'll leave it a few days. You know, let the dust settle a bit.
Oh, why? Scared how they'll react?
No.
We'll go round then. I'm sure they'll be made up to find out you're marrying Robbie the robber.
You marrying him? Yeah.
You're more stupid than I thought then.
Well, if you don't like it, you know what you can do.
Don't worry. I've already decided to move out. I'm going to stay in a B&B for the next 2 weeks till we go to Spain.
I don't want to go.
You have to. You were off before the holidays. We'll be getting pulled in.
I feel sick.
You were all right last night, stuffing your face with chocolate.
I feel like I've got a temperature.
You're not hot.
Please, Dad, they'll only send me back home again.
Look, I've got to get going myself.
Well, I'll just stay in bed until my mum comes home. She'll be back soon.
I'll give him a ring and tell him I'm staying off.
So, what happened? Did he go back to yours?
Yeah, you might have done.
I knew he would. He was all over you. Talk about Daisy dancing.
Oh, were we that bad?
I thought at one point I was going to have to go and get the bouncers to split yous up.
So what did you think?
Very tasty. He was dead muscly.
Tell me about it.
So, did he stay or what?
Well, you know what it's like getting a taxi at that time of night.
I don't believe you. So what was it like? Was he any good?
I didn't have any complaints.
Look, Nicky, can you get off the phone?
Hang on a sec. What's that, Jane?
I'm trying to work here.
I know. I won't be a sec.
Forget it. I'll get off.
No, hang on. Hey, what's up? Is everything all right?
I'm going to have to go.
Why? What's happened? I'll ring you back later, OK?
See you later.
Where are you going? Jay!
What are you doing?
What does it look like?
Leave.
I won't.
It's my mess. I'll clean it up.
I want to do it.
Leave it.
This isn't fair, Jimmy.
What?
Bringing all kinds of strangers back to the house.
Friends.
Playing your music full blast when you knew I had to get up for work in the morning.
It's my house. I'm going to play my records. And I'll play my records.
What's with the music, love?
That's Jimmy.
My son's not well, Ned. He's not going to be able to sleep through that.
Jimmy! Marty wants to wait!
Do you think you could turn it down?
No problem, mate. As soon as she's out of earshot.
The whole sky.
What? Nothing.
She not Clint today?
Nope.
Just wanted to tell him the good news. See, there's a bit of a problem now. Me and Jackie are getting married. There's no way our Clint can go to Spain. He'll miss the wedding.
Like he'll be bothered.
What?
She only saying the other day that you and him finished. He's not going to let you rule his life anymore.
Since you started sticking the knife in, you mean?
He's old enough to make his own decisions.
We'll see.
He's finally seen the light. After 20 years of living in your shadow, he's realised there's more to life than taking orders from Robbie Moffat.
Time to ring me.
Morning. Is it something I said?
He's just ignorant.
Is everything all right?
Not really. Robbie and Jackie are getting married.
She wants the house.
And our wills.
She's a bloody case, isn't she? Flaming hell, I've heard everything now.
Unbelievable, isn't it?
Well, you got to stand your ground, mate. Fight it all the way. I tell you, that's what I did when I found my wife bang at her.
Thing is, I don't think I stand a chance.
Why not?
Well, you know, I had that breakdown recently.
Yeah.
Well, she reckons she's going to bring it up in court. Say I'm not fit to look after our wills.
You are joking.
Wish I was, mate.
Flaming hell, that's ruthless.
Doesn't matter that I've got everything under control. Doesn't matter that the doctors reckon I'm back to normal. As soon as that judges the words breakdown or mental illness, I'll be out on my backside without a penny to my name. He'll just sign everything over to her, won't he?
And you've done nothing wrong?
No.
Well, it doesn't seem right to me. I mean, she's the one who had the... Well, you know, had the affair. Well, doesn't that give you the case to get the house and the kid yourself?
She didn't have an affair, though, did she? Not in the eyes of the law, anyway.
Oh, what do you mean?
It'd only count if she'd been with a fella.
What?
Lesbian affairs don't exist, apparently.
But an affair's an affair, whether it's with a man, a woman, or a bloody animal.
Not according to my solicitor.
So what are you going to do?
Sit tight.
And what?
Well, I'm thinking if I make enough mess, have enough all-night parties, she might get that fed up, she'll throw her hand in. Move out herself.
I thought, yeah.
Is Jackie in?
She said she'd be back soon.
I'll tell her I'm looking for her.
Yeah, they were all yellow. I came along.
What are you doing here?
I need to speak to you.
Is your phone broke?
Please, and she just let me in. I need to talk to you. All right, an orange, please.
I think she's making a massive mistake.
Why?
He's off his head. Even Clint thinks he's a loon, and that's his own brother.
Are you sure this isn't about you?
What do you mean?
Oh, you're really close, aren't you? New boyfriend comes along, ruins everything, threatens to take your best mate away from you.
You think I'm jealous?
Katie, the same thing happened with Nathan.
That was different.
Oh.
I thought Nathan was wrong for her, but I didn't think he was dangerous.
Robbie's never come across like that to me.
No.
No, he just seems like a really nice, down-to-earth Liverpool lad. Just normal, really.
She's so clever, also covers it up.
Hello, kid. You all right? Sobered up yet?
Oh, just about.
Catch you later.
Oh, cheer up. Things can't be that bad between you. Can they?
Yeah.
Oh, have you spoken to Jackie about it? What'd she say?
We're not talking.
Went down well, then.
She wants me to move out.
Well, there's a vodka in there.
All right, Mr. Evans.
What are you drinking, Stevie?
Just orange.
Orange? You gonna get a jelly and ice cream to go with it? Get yourself a proper drink.
I've got a BMW to service this afternoon.
You're out with the boss now, remember? We can roll back whenever we want.
Oh. All right, then.
I'll give him a bell. Tell him to put somebody else on the job. £2 a bitter when you're ready, please, lad. Might as well get us a seat, son.
Oh, yeah, OK.
Thanks. It's doing me head in. Every time she goes out, she comes back and she tells me who you've been talking to. I mean, I'm getting weekly reports on who you've copped for and who you've brought home. I can't take it anymore.
Oh, but we agreed we weren't going to see each other anymore.
I know. And I've tried, I swear I have, but it's doing me head in. I'm thinking about it all the time.
It's not fair on Nicky.
I don't care anymore.
I do.
Please, just let me have one kiss.
Jerome.
Please.
Don't.
You know, I've been dying for this.
I think you should go home.
No.
you doing?
Okay.
Let's have a look. What, 102? Blimey, I better call the doctor.
Oh, no, there's no need. I felt better than I did this morning.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
You don't have look pale.
Oh, no, I'm all right, honest.
Your mum's on her way back from her nins. She's going to get you some comics and keep you going. She's dead worried about you, you know. Anyway, give us a shout if you need anything, right?
Okay.
What can I do? Every time I try and talk to Jackie, she goes off her head.
Well, you shouldn't let a dodgy boyfriend ruin a beautiful friendship.
Did your husband get married, remember?
Well, surely that just proves how much she cares about him.
Even their Mike and her dad think he's bad news.
Well, that's all the more reason to give her your support. I'll get us a refill.
So, what do you think of my little business, then?
Little?
Enjoying it?
Yeah, too right. Well better than the last place I worked.
That's the riddle for you. I'd never come back over here.
No?
Not now.
Mind you, it's a bit of a trek through the tunnel.
Oh, that reminds me, Stevie. I'm going to have to get a car sorted for you. That heap of scrap you've got's just messing up your forecourt.
Yeah, I know. I've been trying to save up for another one.
No need. I'll sort it.
Really?
Can't have my princess ferried around in a rust bucket, can I? I'll have a word with Pete in the morning.
Nice one.
So, how was Jackie this morning?
Jackie? Jackie, you?
Your wife? She didn't look too happy when we all pitched up last night.
Yeah, well, don't be worrying about her. She'll be gone in a couple of weeks.
Really? Things really got that bad?
I think last night put the top hat on it. Don't think she'll be sticking around much longer now.
I'm sorry.
Sorry? What have you got to be sorry about? I'm made up, me. Didn't think she'd last this long.
So, you getting on with the boys, okay?
Yeah, okay, most of the time.
They're not a bad lot, as long as you keep on top of them.
Well, it's just a bit weird, you know, with the connection between me and you sometimes.
How do you mean?
Well, me going out with your daughter, I think that they think I'm there to spy on them.
You are, aren't you?
Am I?
That's why I gave you the job.
What?
I'm joking with you yourself, get. Your face. Although, on a more serious note, it probably wouldn't do to get too alley-pally with them.
Why's that?
Well, you've got to consider the future, haven't you, Stevie, lad? One day I might not be around. Might be you that's doing the hiring and firing. Cheers.
Hello?
In here.
What are you doing, girl? Through me drawers?
What's this?
It's a letter from Susanna's solicitor. When did that come?
And this? And this? And these? What the hell's going on?
Nothing.
Nothing? You're some sort of legal guardian to Max Farnham's kids?
No.
Well, that's what it says here.
No, I'm in charge of their money.
Since when?
Since the other day.
These are dated weeks ago.
OK, so I first got told a few weeks ago.
Well, why didn't you tell me?
I was gonna.
When? After it was all sorted?
I was waiting for the right moment.
That's what you've done, isn't it? Got it all done and dusted behind me back. You and bloody Blue Eyes.
No.
Liar.
I didn't want to upset you.
Liar.
I swear.
You're sleeping with him, aren't you?
With who?
Max Farnham.
Oh, don't be stupid.
I want the truth, Jackie.
I am telling you the truth.
You lying slag. You told me you'd hardly spoken to him. You're giving him one, aren't you? Aren't you?
No. What's going on? Nothing.
Do you mind giving us a bit of privacy?
Jackie, is everything okay? Yeah, everything's fine.
Come here, babe. I'm sorry I shouted at you. I mean to upset you.
Jackie. Give me a shout if you need me.
Hello?
right, son.
You're early?
Psh. Flaming hell. How many have you had?
A couple.
A couple of gallons.
I need a burst.
Well, don't do it here. Get upstairs.
Jeff is fantastic.
Is he in the same state as you?
He's buying me a car.
You're joking. Hey, hang on a minute while I just sort out this soup for her, haven't he?
Is he sick again?
Just give us a sec.
How you doing, mate?
Okay.
What's up?
Nothing.
Slap?
Nothing.
Little skiver.
Oh, don't tell me daddy'll kill me.
Thought you were into school?
Not anymore.
That is me thinking you're a swat.
I'm not going back there, ever.
Don't think you've got much choice, mate.
They can't make me.
I think they can.
Oh, I can't stand anymore.
Stop what? Something happened. That Miss Phelan one hasn't been giving you any stick, has she?
No.
Then what? You been in a fight?
Kind of.
How many times do I have to tell you? Reach with the left, jab with the right. Show them you can handle yourself. Problem solved.
Get off.
Oh, yeah, sorry, I forgot you were sick. So, come on, how did this scrap come about?
Doesn't matter.
Oh, don't go home, Hardy, on me, I want to know.
It doesn't matter, I'll handle it myself.
Hey, that's my boy.
Ow.
Never drop your guard.
What are you doing?
I'm tidying my house.
I told you this morning I was going to do it.
When? Next week? Next year?
I told you. If you don't like it, you know what you can do.
I'm going nowhere.
Neither am I. Where's the tally?
Upstairs.
Why?
Because it's mine, that's why. I bought it and I'm going to watch it on my own. Oh, and by the way, can you make yourself scarce tomorrow night? I'm going to need the kitchen and the living room from 8 o'clock onwards.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I'm having a few mates around for a party. I don't know what time it'll go on till.
Fair enough.
As you said, if you don't like it, you know what you can do.
I'm not bothered. I'll put my headphones on. As long as you don't disturb the kids.
I was going to tell you, you know.
Just that you're going behind me back.
What do you expect? When every time I even look at Harry or Max, there's murder.
You wound me up because you lied to me. Jackie, if we're going to get married, we can't have any secrets. Can we?
No.
Come here, wife-to-be. I really love you. Do you know that?
Yeah.
And I want to spend the rest of my life with you. Or not?
Since you asked me so nicely, no.
Seems right. He's hijacked everything. Every thought or feeling I come to, Jimmy's already been there.
It's been the most perfect moment to tell me.
Tell you what?
Tell you what, wait and see Friday, 8 o'clock, Channel 4. A new arrival next. ER's in a couple of minutes here on 4.